Statue of Belgium's King Leopold II has been removed from Antwerp and may not be returned. The statue was burned and hit with red paint during anti-racism protests following George Floyd's death. A growing number of people are now campaigning to remove statues of the colonial era king. His troops killed and maimed millions of people at rubber plantations in the Congo. And then in London, protesters watched as the statue of Scottish merchant and slave owner Robert Milligan was taken down following a petition for its removal. Milligan was the driving force behind the construction of London's West India docks, which were used to trade slave-harvested goods from the Caribbean. Meantime, in Bristol, demonstrators aren't waiting for monuments to be removed. On Sunday, protesters tore down the statue of a notorious British slave trader and philanthropist. Nick Robertson takes a look at how Britons are now confronting their colonial past.
Britain lurched around a corner confronting the worst of its colonial racist past Sunday as protesters at a Black Lives Matter march in the port city of Bristol toppled a statue of 17th century slave trader Edward Colston, then trundled it through the city's tarmac streets and tossed it into the sea, the same harbour where his slave ships once docked.
It could only have happened that way. It could only have been ripped down. What is that doing up there? It would be like you having somebody that has abused your family all your life, you know who he is, and I get a statue and I put it in your front garden.
Colston and his employer, the Royal Africa Company, dominated the transatlantic slave trade. He helped ship an estimated 100,000 people from Africa to the US and the Caribbean. One in five of them died along the way. Colston, whose name adorns buildings, streets, even schools in the normally restful city, was also a philanthropist. The controversy over his racist past has been brewing for years.
We politically had tried to go around. We had gone to debates and meetings. We had meetings with the council, meetings with Colston Hall, radio debates, TV debates, and people were, if I can say, pussyfooting around.
Condemnation with caveats came quickly.
I will not support or indulge those who break the law. If you want to change the urban landscape, you can stand for election or vote for someone who will.
Similar long simmering frustrations over contentious Confederate statues in America are coming to a head too.
So is this the moment when the UK, the United States and others recognise the pain of the past, that Black Lives Matter, and reimagine their countries on new values?
In the fabled university city of Oxford, that's the pressing question.
Now is the time to change and do things in a different way, rewriting history. And if you have to take a statue from there and put in a museum, so be it.
The statue, Cecil Rhodes, a leading colonialist who built his fortune off black labour and bequeathed scholarships here.
In this country, there is such a ingrained sort of systemic racism that hasn't been questioned or looked at or sort of dealt with for far too long.
No sign Oxford plans to grant the protesters their wish. And the conversation about that new future yet to happen too. Nick Robertson, CNN, Oxford, England.
Well, monuments to Cecil John Rhodes have a history of controversy. Back in 2015, his statue was removed from the University of Cape Town after weeks of protest there at UCT. Students had created a Rhodes Must Fall campaign saying his legacy was tainted with racism. Well, let's go to Farai Savenzo. He joins me now from Nairobi, Kenya. He was actually there covering the Rhodes protests back in 2015. And Farai, hi. I just want to get your reaction, and particularly the perspective there from Africa, to all of these protests, which all link back to, you know, the death of George Floyd.
Absolutely, Robert. I mean, we had the chairperson of the African Union, Mr. Mustafa Faki Mohammed, basically saying, look, you know, back in 1964, the African Union, then the Organization of African Unity, was very, very behind the fact that racism in the United States must stop, especially against citizens who are of African descent. And of course, what you're mentioning right now with, you know, with the whole idea of, you know, the roads must fall, the sculptures going down in Bristol and everything. We are a continent that is completely tainted with, you know, that what Nick was talking about, the pain of the past, which is completely all over the net. Why should we have Cecil John Rhodes statues all over Cape Town? And why should we have him buried in Zimbabwe, a country that's like, you know, completely turned against the idea of not having any land? So it's a live issue, Robin. It's been going on for quite a while. And of course, even in Bristol, Mr. Colston, whose statue was thrown in the river, my daughter went to the Colston Girls School, and she told me yesterday, you know, she feels free when that statue fell in the water. So it's a live issue, and it needs to be addressed.
Farai Savenza, thanks so much for joining us there live from Nairobi. Thanks, Farai. So Banksy has a suggestion for replacing the toppled statue we just mentioned of that slave trader Edward Colston. In a sketch posted on Instagram, the elusive street artist illustrates the moment demonstrators removed the statue in Bristol. And in the caption, Banksy says, here's an idea that caters for both those who miss the Colston statue and those who don't. He then suggests pulling it from the water, tying rope around its neck, and commissioning life-size bronze figures of the protesters who pulled it down. Well, Banksy has publicly expressed support for Black Lives Matter, for the Black Lives Matter movement, sharing another post on Sunday with a painting of a vigil candle burning an American flag, writing, "People of color are being failed by the system."